Hey, welcome back to Happy Little No Trees. Hey, welcome back to Happy Little No Trees. Today we're going to be talking a little bit more about my film emulation thingy that I've been working on. And if you have questions, feel free to ask them. And please offer suggestions if you see me doing something stupid. But I talked about it in a previous video. The whole goal of this was to create little mats so that when we look at this footage, we have a red footage, green footage, and blue footage. Oops, we got something going on wrong there. We're going to figure that out. But we put those back together and we create a negative image. And that negative image then gets subtracted from this projector light. So we have our projector light and we can set that projector light to anything we want. I have other nodes that I've been playing around with how best to, you know, kind of tweak, edit, and color grade this footage. But what we have going on is this idea of, if you think about it, film, red, green, and blue, stuck together, light passes through, hits the projector screen, bounces back into your eyeballs, and that's what you see. And so where there is no red, green, and blue, you have pure pass-through light. And that's where the density layer of the film stock bled out. And that's why we can take, if we take off that, you can see with how this is set up, the color generator allows us to say our projector light is a red light. Our projector light is a green light, blue light. Or this is a carbon arc, I think is what I have it set for. So a similar profile to that of a carbon arc old school light. And we can do some fun things, like we can turn off in this mixer, we can turn off blue, and you can see that whatever was coming through that blue channel, which I didn't like, because I've been playing around with all these setups, is we have more of this kind of, it's only showing red and green coming through and subtracting from this light pass. If we hop over to Fusion, you'll see layout presets, it keeps taking me around today, and when I jump into the Fusion and making me change my layout, which isn't good because I'm recording and then I'm doing putting things back in and doing all that, and so everything needs to be the same, otherwise it makes it hard. So yeah, we talked about how this is working a little bit. So we have our footage coming in. We're actually putting it in linear. And then we're running it through a technicolor three-strip process that kind of refines it into three different channels of red, green, and blue. And then we're using Thatcher Freeman's dye simulator to emulate the dyes. And so we can see up there in the viewer that we now have using status and transmittance. We took that red, which was here, and turned it into blue or cyan. And then I've been playing around with different ways to do that. I keep ending up back here using a Luma mixer that then creates a mat. And that mat gets combined with our end outgo mat. I've been playing with different variations of what seems to work the best. And what we have coming out is our red out right there. And the cool thing is, I did it before, and we can set it up real quick now, is we can go here, we have our outs that go back to the color page, those are just media out nodes, but we can just drop in two background nodes here and here, and then we can go here, or we can go like this, and so this is on top, and we're going to set this to screen, and then we're going to set this one to screen. And so this is in my latest update to what I'm doing, is to be able to, while I'm in Fusion, kind of see what I'm doing. So I'm not blind to what's going on when I get back to the color page, because you're jumping back and forth. So now we have, as you can see, our negative coming in here. You can see we had some weird stuff going on. Oh, that's why we have a matte going into the blue key. It should be this going into there. So you can see what we had going on here is this should go here, this should just go away, And that fixes, this should fix that. And then we have our blue out. We can see that real quick. Or we can hop over here and we have our negative image. And that negative image, we can take this background node and tell it we want the color to be carbon arc, which is what we have on our color page. And we'll just crank the alpha up so it's a solid. And we'll just drop this merge over there. And now we would do difference. And so when we turn that one on to our viewers, you can see we have our image. That is now, we went from here to here, which is very similar to what we're getting on the color page. The only difference with what we got going on the color page is that we have these guys blending back together at different ratios, and so we can have a little control over how the ultimate final look is and still have that projector-like control on the final image. So right now this image, we turned off all of our blue. We can bring that back up if we wanted because we fixed it. And there we have kind of a more blued out image. We can kind of make some tweaks. Look at, yeah, now we're getting somewhere working that image. Just kind of, things work in reverse because these are technically how this gets put back together. You're working in the negative. And so things that you want to be positive, they're actually negative. And things that you want to be negative, they're actually positive. Dials and things, you gotta remember. So yeah, anyways, this infusion was these numbers that I have set up for the Dysim. This would be 5384 Kodak Eastman, kind of an Indiana Jones. The numbers that I've kind of settled on, that best model after the curves. And then this is Kodak 2383, the most, pretty much the common print stock of the last 20 years. And that's what we have making our image and having full control over that final product because we've created this pass-through mat that we can see through. And yeah, it's kind of fun. So the other thing is, I've been working on how best, if we hop over to this page, how best to work it. So here we have our footage down below, and we can go to the color page, and we can kind of see, let's switch so I can see what I'm doing, bring up the timeline. So if we go down to the below one, it's just our footage coming in. There's nothing going on with it. But I've been playing around with, can we shape the image a little bit here? Like if we get the image from the camera, negative camera, and it's a little like, ugh. Yeah. Can we edit it there? And then instead, and then once you've done that, you can render, you can either render that video file out as a 4444 ProRes and have it there, or you can go into an adjustment layer. So this is an adjustment layer. We can open that adjustment layer in Fusion, and you can see we have that node tree that I showed you all lined up with everything going on, making our fancy dancy mat and coming together with our outgoing viewer so we can see what's going on in our viewer, and we can see our negative that we put together and all that jazz, and we can tweak it and affect it in here, and then we come to the color page. And the color page is doing it all in that adjustment layer sitting above. So it's taking the footage below, reading it, reading whatever footage that was, and so whatever edits and tweaks and changes you made there are then populated into this adjustment clip. There's some smoothness issues with updating and the Fusion cache and things like that. And so I haven't really figured out the best workflow for working on it. And you might notice this image looks a little bit different. It's because what I've been doing for the Dysim is making it more, this would be kind of a, so I have a client that I'm currently just doing some pre-viz look dev for him. He just filmed a short film, but the look of it and in the creative brief that he gave was like the 2004 or something like that, Punisher film. And so I just thought, hey, it'd be fun to take a couple clips of the footage that he gave me and work it up in this fashion and see if we can come to make it. So this is set up in the same way Punisher, the Thomas Jane one, was filmed, which was a Kodak 5279, and then it was printed to Kodak 2383. And that's how we've set it up, and that I've been working on what is a good, robust way of doing that. And then the second thing is, the footage he gave me is in B-RAW, and so I'm used to it not being in B-RAW. I'm used to getting a log footage, putting it into linear, and figuring all that out. What is the best way to get the image that I want? So maybe I can reach out to him and see if he'll let me, you know, show a little bit of what I'm doing in a future video of the footage of his for a short film. So that is my crazy film emulation thing. And if you have any questions or comments or suggestions on how to make it better, feel free. I really don't know how to package this up to share it. Right now I have variations of what I'm doing in adjustment layers that I've put into PowerBin so I can jump between projects a little bit more seamlessly. But yeah, it's kind of a play around at your own, and it's finicky, and figuring out how to control it and then even shape and steer the image as you're putting it back together, because you're taking it apart in this really unique way and you're processing it and you're putting it back together. I haven't really gotten a full grasp on what I am even doing. But yeah, this would be, it's funny, the footage that I've been doing for him has really had a very unique feel to it, because it's like there are moments when I'm looking at shots from Punisher and I'm like, it's that, I got it, it's right there. And then I make like some small tweak to the whole setup and I lose it and I'm gone for like 3 hours trying to figure out, what the heck did I change that made it be not what it is anymore? And so, yeah, I feel like I was getting really close. Like, this is, I love this. This is one of my favorite things about this. Instant pushing in the direction of technicolor two-strip. The only two colors we have coming into subtracting off our light source are red and green. And you just get this really old, antique-y feel to your image, like, instantly. And you can, like, blend that right back in, blend that back out, but you're just pulling out all your blue dye layer in your print film stock. Anyways, if you like that, I'll find out if I can share footage from the clips that I'm working on, and that might be a future video on Happy Little No Trees. So, yeah, crazy secret way of doing things. And this isn't even in DaVinci Resolve 19.1. So I probably put a clickbaity title in the YouTube. I'm sorry. But I want views. I want likes. You can go on my website if you like these videos. There's a, and go on any of the blog entries. There's a place to buy me a coffee. I could use some. I have kids. They keep me up. You know. Anyways, until next time, buy me a coffee. It'd be great. Ciao, ciao.